हेलो फ्रेंड्स, सो टुडे वी स्टार्ट अ न्यू फाइलम आर्थ्रोपोडा एंड एनेलिडा, सॉरी एनेलिडा एंड आर्थ्रोपोडा. ओके, सो बिफोर वी स्टार्ट दिस फाइलम वी मस्ट नो अबाउट सम टू टर्म्स, डिफरेंट टर्म्स. लाइक द फर्स्ट वन इज मेटामेरिकली सेगमेंटेड. वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस वर्ड? सो द एनिमल इज मेटामेरिकली सेगमेंटेड. ओके, now what is metamerically segmented means body is divided into the so many segments and the almost segments are same internally, okay, and externally both. So the segments are same and they are divided through a septa, and the each and every segments are same according to their morphology externally and internally. It's called metamerically segmented body. Okay, so first thing is metamerical segmented body. So annelids have the metamerically segmented body, means all the segments are same and the body is divided into so many segments. Okay, second thing, ki there are two terms according to your circulatory system. Okay, first is open type of circulatory system and second is closed type of circulatory system. So first of all, as you know ki annelids and arthropods both are the true coelomate animals, means they have their body cavity. Okay, so two type of circulatory system is there, open type of circulatory system and closed type of circulatory system. Now you know ki annelida and arthropoda both are the true coelomate animals. Now what is true coelomate animals? They have a true body cavity. Now you know the coelom is body cavity. So they both have the true body cavity, means true coelom, means they have the body cavity. Now second thing, first of all, open type of circulatory system. Open circulatory system. Now what is open type of circulatory system? For an example, this is the structure of a heart and this is the blood vessels. This is an example, or this is the symbolic diagram. Okay, now these blood vessels are opens into the body cavity. This is the body cavity. Assume that this is the body cavity, and heart have a specific pore for entering the blood into the heart. Okay, so in the open type of circulatory system, all the animals they have the respiratory organs. Okay, so the respiratory organs purify the blood, means the deoxygenated blood converted into oxygenated blood at the level of, or at the surface of a respiratory organ. Okay, so wahan se the oxygenated blood comes into the body coelom. Wo body coelom mein aata hai, means blood. So the coelom is full with or filled with blood. मीन्स सिलोम है वो पूरा ब्लड से भरा हुआ होता है. वाई? बिकॉज जो रेस्पिरेटरी ऑर्गन है वहां से ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड आता है सिलोम में या बॉडी कैविटी में. सो बिकॉज द बॉडी कैविटी इज फिल्ड विथ ब्लड, दैट्स वाई इट्स कॉल्ड हीमोसील. इट्स कॉल्ड हीमोसील. हीमोसील मीन्स द बॉडी कैविटी इज फिल्ड विथ ब्लड. सो नाउ this blood is going into the heart with the help of this pore. Okay, then heart pumps the heart pumps the blood and push the blood into the blood vessels, and then blood goes to the recipient or receptive organs, ki jahan pe blood ki zarurat hai wahan pe blood jata hai. Now blood, ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड वहां पे गया, देन वहां पे ऑर्गन ने यूज किया, देन ऑर्गन से कलेक्ट होके ब्लड आता है फिर से हीमोसील में. ओके, एंड देन रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक में, रेस्पिरेटरी ऑर्गन के थ्रू फिर से हीमोसील में जाता है, सॉरी रेस्पिरेटरी ऑर्गन में जाता है. सो जो ब्लड है वो रेस्पिरेटरी ऑर्गन के थ्रू हीमोसील में आता है, हीमोसील से वो हार्ट में जाता है, हार्ट से ऑर्गन में जाता है, ऑर्गन से फिर से हीमोसील में आता है. ओके, और हीमोसील से फिर से रेस्पिरेटरी ऑर्गन में जाता है. सो द होल ब्लड ओपन्स इन ओपन इनटू द हीमोसील, और बॉडी कैविटी में सारा ब्लड जो है वो ओपन होता है बॉडी कैविटी में. दैट्स व्हाई इट्स कॉल्ड ओपन टाइप ऑफ सर्कुलेटरी सिस्टम. Okay. Now, second thing, what is closed type of circulatory system? Now, the closed type of circulatory system. So, in the closed type of circulatory system, the blood vessels are closed. Means, जैसे हमारे अंदर होता है, means the blood is open into the respiratory organ, then the oxygenated blood comes into the heart and heart pumps the blood to the organs. Organ से फिर से वो आता है respiratory organ में, heart में, या फिर direct respiratory organ में, और respiratory organ से फिर से heart में, और फिर से means single circulation or double circulation. या तो वो हार्ट से ऑर्गन में जाता है, और ऑर्गन से सीधा रेस्पिरेटरी ऑर्गन में जाता है, सिंगल सर्कुलेशन. और डबल सर्कुलेशन इज कि रेस्पिरेटरी ऑर्गन से वो हार्ट में आता है, हार्ट से ऑर्गन में जाता है, ऑर्गन से फिर से हार्ट में आता है, हार्ट उसको रेस्पिरेटरी ऑर्गन में भेजता है. इट इज अ सिंगल सॉरी डबल सर्कुलेशन. सो इट इज अ क्लोज टाइप ऑफ सर्कुलेटरी सिस्टम. मीन्स ब्लड है वो कहीं पे भी ओपन नहीं होता, और वो कहीं पे भी जमा नहीं होता. मीन्स इट्स कॉल्ड क्लोज टाइप ऑफ सर्कुलेटरी सिस्टम. Okay, so open and closed type of circulatory system, clear? Sabko? Okay, now we move to the general character of phylum Annelida. Why I am explaining this thing? Because Annelida have the different characteristic. First, the general characteristic, where is the habitats of Annelida? So, Annelidas are found in the fresh water, marine water and terrestrial. All. It is also found as a parasite on the ectoparasite on the animal. Okay, different animals pe wo ectoparasite bhi hote hain, like leech. Okay, the blood sucking animal, it is ectoparasites. Okay, second, the body structure is cylindrical body with a metamerical segments. Body is segmented, metamerically segmented, cylindrical elongated body. Okay, second thing, the outer layer is covered by a cuticle layer, okay, which is protective layer. Second thing, ki unke body surface ke andar muscles layer bhi hai. So they help to locomotion. Wo muscle layer hai, unko locomotion mein help karta hai, wo locomote hota hai. So the leech and then earthworm, both are doing the same function, means they contraction and relaxation of muscles and they can move. Okay, they can locomote. Now, what about the third animal, means Nereis? Nereis have a lateral side, a parapodia. Pairs of so many parapodias according to their segments. So, each and every segments have one pair of parapodia on the lateral side of body. For an example, this is the body of leech. Sorry, this is the body of Nereis. Okay. So, body is segmented, so many segments are there, and each and every segments have a one pair of lateral parapodia, like this, lateral parapodia, which helps to locomote, okay, which helps to locomote. Generally, Nereis is found in the marine habitat, in mud, okay, so the parapodias are help into the swimming and locomotion and burrowing. Okay, it is burrowing animal also. So it helps to dig the mud or help to create a burrow. Okay, so parapodias are there. Second, the annelids have the closed type of circulatory system. They have the closed type of circulatory system. Iske andar closed type of circulatory system hai. Okay, so closed type of circulatory system yahan pe aap dekh sakte hain. Second thing, ki food habits are different. Okay, secondly, ki they have a specific nephridia for excretion. Nephridia hai for excretion. Then they are different because they are unique. Why? Because the two animals, means leech and earthworm, these two animals are hermaphrodite. Means they are monoecious. But Nereis is a dioecious animal. Means oh, male and female both are different. Sexes are not separate. Sorry, sexes are separate in Nereis and sexes are not separate in earthworm and leech. So, two different types of animal. One hai, ek dioecious hai, ek monoecious hai. Monoecious, any male and female, both gonads are present in a single animal like leech and earthworm, and male and female both are different in nares. Okay, so ये एक uniqueness है annelid phylum की. Okay, second thing कि इनका जो fertilization है वो external है and development है वो direct है, इनके अंदर direct development है. Okay, so these are the unique typical phenomena. So पैरापोडिया आ गए लोकोमोशन के लिए, देन अ यूनिक फिनोमेना और द वेल डेवलप्ड थिंग बिफोर दिस मींस एस्केलमेंथिस और प्लेटिलमेंथिस से थोड़ा एडवांस एक ये है कि दे हैव द सेंसरी ऑर्गन्स, इनके अंदर सेंसरी ऑर्गन्स है, दे हैव द वेंट्रल नर्व कॉर्ड, इनके अंदर एक पूरा डबल वेंट्रल नर्व कॉर्ड है, मींस वेंट्रल साइड दे हैव अ नर्व कॉर्ड व्हिच इज मेड अप ऑफ सो मेनी नर्व सेल्स एंड नर्व टिश्यूज. देन the anterior side of body they have a nerve ring which is made up of nerve ganglion. Nerve ganglion means a bunch or a group of nerve cells, they form a nerve ganglion and this nerve ganglion creates a nerve ring. Ring type structure hai wo hum 7th chapter mein detail mein jayenge. They create a nerve ring. So the anterior side of body there is a nerve ring and the ventral means body ke niche ke part ventral double nerve cord is present. So this is the unique phenomena of annelida. Okay, so this is all about the annelida. Okay, now we move towards the arthropoda. Arthropoda is a famous phylum because the world jisni a world mein population hai uski second to and third population hai wo arthropod ki hai. मीन्स अगर आप सोचे कि 100% ऑफ एनिमल वर्ल्ड में है सो उसमें से 75% ऑफ एनिमल बिलोंगिंग फ्रॉम फाइलम आर्थ्रोपोडा. इट इज द लार्जेस्ट फाइलम ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड. ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड में सबसे लार्जेस्ट फाइलम है आर्थ्रोपोडा. एंड देर आर सम सर्टेन जनरल कैरेक्टर्स लाइक दे आर ट्रिप्लोब्लास्टिक सिलोमेट बायलेटरलिस्ट सिमेट्रिकल बॉडी. यहाँ भी होगा ट्रिप्लोब्लास्टिक सिलोमेट bilaterally symmetrical body. Okay, now the body is divided into three region: head, thorax and abdomen. Head, thorax and abdomen. Sometimes head and thorax fuse together and form a cephalothorax. Okay, so head and thorax form together, so some in some animals, not all the animals. So body is divided into generally three regions: head, thorax and abdomen. Okay, head, thorax and abdomen. We move to further. Then the body is covered by chitinous layer. Body is covered by chitinous hard cover. उसके ऊपर एक chitinous thick cover होता है जो protect करता है body को from the external environment. Okay, second thing ki digestive tract is well developed hai from compared to annelida. Then nervous system is like annelidan, unke utne inme jo nervous system hai wo same annelida ke jaisa hai, nerve ring hai and ventral nerve cord hai. Now the special character of arthropoda is the appendages are joined and muscular movement is there in their appendages, so it have the arthropod means joints appendages. That's why it's called arthropod. Joint appendages are there, so they for the locomotion, for food capturing. Second thing, they have some sensory organs or well developed sensory organs, means they bear eyes. Unke andar eyes hai, simple eye or compound eye, there are two type of eye. Then they have the chemoreceptor, they have the photoreceptor organ, they have the antenna or tentacles. Unke andar tentacles hai, antenna hai, like cockroach ke andar antenna hai. Then some animals, rather aquatic animals, they have stetocyst or it's called balancing organ. They maintain the balance, body balance, they sense the temperature, etc. So it is the useful for sense or the behavior of animal. Okay, so these are the sensory organs and the excretory organs. Now it have the variety in excretory organ and respiratory organ. Dono ke andar they have some varieties. For an example, in the respiratory organ they have the gills, book gills, lungs, book lungs, spiracles, spiracles means respiratory tracheas are there. So they have the varieties of respiratory organs. Second, they have varieties in excretory organ also. So the insecta class, which is class of arthropoda, the further division of arthropoda. So phylum ke baad class aata hai. So class insecta, they all have a malpighian tubules. Malpighian tubules for the excretion. They absorb the nitrogenous waste from the body cavity and then it secrete the into the digestive tract and then it goes to the outside of body. Second thing, in the aquatic arthropods like crustacea, means crabs and prawns, they are crustaceans. So they have the green gland, okay, and some spiders and all, they have coxal gland for excretion. Okay, so excretory organs are different. Now, sexes are separate. Okay, male and female both are different. Fertilization, internal, they have internal fertilization and development is indirect through some larva stages and then they become adult. So, development is indirect and fertilization is internal. Okay, now, what about the, second thing, कि एक जो है ये सबसे largest phylum है. Second, the useful and harmful both animals are belonging from arthropoda. For an example, if you see the honeybee is useful. If you see the lac, जहाँ से लाख मिलता है, lac insect, okay, which is also useful. Then silk moth, bombax mori जिसको बोलते हैं, silk moth is important. Like some arthropods are vector for disease. For an example, Aedes मच्छर mosquito, then Culex mosquito, Anopheles mosquito, they are the vector of different diseases like Anopheles se malaria hota hai. Okay, so paste is also there. Locust jo hai, jo crop ko damage karta hai in the agricultural land, locust means grasshopper, jo damage karta hai crop ko. So these are the examples of harmful and beneficial. Or except that some ant, then spiders, then cockroach, then scorpion. These are the examples of arthropoda. एक second example है, एक बहुत ही important बात कि एक living fossil है जो arthropoda के अंदर है, limulus जिसको बोलते हैं king crab. Okay, which is a unique example of arthropod. So वो आपको याद रखना है कि it is a living fossil. वो उसकी कैरेक्टर्स कुछ ऐसा है कि वो फॉसिल है. ओके, द यूनिक कैरेक्टरिस्टिक दे हैव. सो लिम्बुलस मींस क्रिंग क्रैब, इट इज आल्सो एग्जांपल ऑफ आर्थ्रोपोडा. सो इट इज ऑल अबाउट द आर्थ्रोपोडा एंड एनेलिडा. याद रखता हूँ, नेक्स्ट लेक्चर में देखेंगे मोल्यूस्का एंड एकिनोडर्मेटा. ओके, सो यहाँ तक रखता हूँ, बाय.